The next part that I'm going to talk about is the eagle and the shield and some tips related to those things. Just as a little note, you do not need to do the registered symbol. This is a type element, so that never needs to be drawn. And there are a few other things that you don't want to manually draw. As one of those examples, you don't need to manually draw the stars. Those are a shape primitive. And there's no reason not to just use those sort of as they come. I'm going to turn off the fleur-de-lis now because it does cross over parts of the eagle, which is an important part of the construction, but it keeps me from being able to see those. I'm going to add a new layer that I'm going to call eagle. And I'm going to draw again, if you'll remember, I'm looking to do half of this. I want to do either the left or the right hand portion, the head. I'll deal with as a separate element. So you could go ahead and sort of skip over that part and layer it in after the fact, or what have you. But specifically the wings, the tail section, the legs are independent of those. They're separate. So that I will do after the fact because I do want it to be on top. And then of course the shield goes after that. As far as the shape primitive for the star is concerned, if you try to just draw your star, they sort of twirl as you're drawing. And to keep that from happening, you hold your shift key down. Mine looks crazy and looks like it's building a second star because I still have that really thick stroke turned on with mine. So I'm going to turn mine down to 1 or 2 points at most right now. And again, for visualization as I'm drawing, I am probably going to do it in something other than red. And I'll add in the color as necessary. One other tip, if you hold down your option or your alt key as you're drawing, it does it from the center out, and it's so much easier to gauge size when you're doing that rather than trying to draw from the edge. So I almost always do it with the option or the alt key held down because it allows me to gauge my size more effectively and make sure I have what I want and all that kind of thing. So that looks pretty close for the star. Obviously not in green, but that gets me what I need to. And that can be on the layer with eagle, or it can be on the layer with the fleur-de-lis. The stars that are used across the shield clearly come later after I've drawn the shield. But I do have a couple of techniques regarding that. And I'll mention those as well. But for now, I'm going to go ahead and start to draw the eagle. Not saying it's impossible to do the eagle shape primitives, but I can't think of a particularly good or easy way of doing that. So I'm going to draw it with the pen tool. I will use the angular approach just so that you can see sort of how that shakes out and I don't have to do it multiple ways. And I ought to lock the fleur-de-lis layer so I don't accidentally make a mistake. All right, so again, think about you're not going to draw around the legs. And you want to consider direction changes. You only want to put points for their big direction changes. I'm deliberately not doing the feathers right now because I'm going to do those in a slightly different way. And just sort of wanted to show you kind of how I would approach this. All right, so that gets me halfway through. Clearly, it's not a good fit right now. I'm going to have to come back in with the convert anchor point tool and significantly modify it. I'm going to make it a brighter color so it shows up a little bit better against that blue. And that might have needed to be two just because there's a weird little sort of plateau there, but I didn't do that on my original drawing, so I'll have to come back and add a point if I need to. And that's not too far off. So, not bad. There were several of them that I actually left as corner points just because they were very abrupt and there wasn't a strong curve happening around them. And that gets me more or less where I need to with the basic shape. I'm going to show you next the flip reflect bit, and then I'll show you what I meant in terms of the feathers. Yeah, I do need to add an extra point there because I can't get the shape better without it. And the path is not active, so there we go. All right. And that's better. All right, so when you get half of it working pretty well, and I'm going to make it something really obnoxious color-wise now. So let's go with some hot pink. Okay. So I've got a pretty bright hot pink line there. I am going to use the reflect tool, find that center line, Alt-click or Option-click, click on copy, get the two parts. I am going to have to use the join function this time, rather than the unite with Pathfinder, because this is not a closed shape. But I can go ahead and do that. And I just drew a box around those two central points at the top and Control J. Same thing at the bottom, Control J. And I get those elements in place. From there, what I have to do is draw in the little elements that are going to be the petals. And for those, I need to draw carefully the shape, and it doesn't have to be one continuous shape, but each little intrusion needs to be a shape. And so I'm just doing a series of these. Don't worry, I'm not worried about closing them on the outside edge, but I'll do this. Now, the question becomes, great, now do I have to do them on the left and the right? I probably should have done this before I did the flip join, because at the moment, yes, I would need to do them on the left and the right. So if you're following along, I got the order wrong because I wasn't thinking about it, but it would work. And I still can make use of it. I'll just cut it and do it again. Okay, so I've got these selected. I want to turn the stroke off and set it to a fill because it is not going to work as it is. And let's see. So you can sort of see how those would work now that I've got them as white shapes. And I can use Shape Builder, I could use Pathfinder. Whatever sort of makes sense, I will make these an additional. I guess white doesn't demonstrate well enough what's going on. But let's make them. Ugh. All selected would be good. Okay. There we go. All right, so the weird bright green color is going to be the one that cuts into the other shape. I'm going to select the bird part, and then I'm going to select the weird green ones that I just made. Now wondering if this is faster than just drawing it in the first place, and that is an excellent question. But I've got Shape Builder, and I'm going to Alt-click on these little bits and pieces that I want to go away. And these will then cut into the shape. And just I'm Alt-clicking on all the parts that I want gone. And now I have, and apparently I skipped one, or let's see what happened with that one. It didn't like that shape for some reason. It usually works. I don't know why that one didn't. But anyway, so you'll end up with the shape that you need. Actually, I have a couple of them that didn't work very well. But overall, I'm getting the petal shape or the feathered shape that I'm looking for. So maybe they were just too skinny before. I don't know. If in doubt, zoom in and try again. Okay, so I've got that selected. I've got Shape Builder, and I will remove the offending parts, and it looks like maybe it worked that time. Nope. I don't know what's going on there. That's just weird. But oh joy, if you ever accidentally turn on the perspective grid, under your view menu, you can turn this silly thing off. It drives people absolutely batty when they accidentally turn it on. Anyway, but that gives you the general idea of the feather part, if you don't want to manually draw those as you're doing the feather in the first place.